Hi guys, and welcome to Paul's DIY. I have just got back from swimming with my little girl, and I didn't take my mobile with me, and when I got back, wow, the amount of notifications I had on YouTube was absolutely fantastic. First of all, welcome to my new subscribers. A couple of weeks back I sent a custom Batman Joker imposter figure to cosplay Chris, just as a little thank you to say thank you for being such an inspiration for my channel, and the response was phenomenal. It really took me back, honestly. I went from 470 subscribers to over 660 subscribers in a matter of hours, and it's blown me away. Your comments, your positive comments on my videos have been fantastic as well. I've had a few suggestions as well that I'm going to take on board and possibly do some customs on. A couple of the comments was why I'm battle damaged this Iron Man figure. To be honest, I didn't even think about doing it, but I've taken your suggestion on board. I'm going to be battle damaging this figure, doing a part 2 video on the Iron Man, and then as a massive thank you to Seth for all the subscribers, I'm going to be giving this bad boy away as a giveaway. So that'll be part 2 Iron Man figure as well as the giveaway. Again, thank you so much, and I'm going to get onto the video of the thumbnail for this one, and it has been, I know I say this for every single custom that I do, but this has been one of my favourites to date. It is something that I don't think anyone's ever thought about doing, and I watched the Batman v Superman movie, and when this scene came up showing the Robin figure, I noticed that it is almost identical to Batman's suit. The only difference is he's got the zip at the front as well as the buckles and obviously the Robin logo. And I thought, looking at the Batman figure that I had, I thought I could easily customize that into the Robin figure. And again, I've not seen any videos on YouTube of anyone doing something similar to this. So again, it's a first. As I mentioned when I did the Nightmare Batman figure, I didn't see anyone doing that on YouTube, so that was a first act for me, and it's the same with the Robin figure. So guys, again, thank you very much for the subscribers. Hope that doesn't fall. Don't fall. The rifle I put with it is quite heavy. I might have to lean that back. Stay. In fact, before I carry on, the new Power Ranger movie has come out. I'll be completely honest, I've seen the trailer. I'm not overly impressed with what the movie looks like by the trailer. I know you can't really judge a movie by the trailer. I will get around to watching it, but what I did like was the new Power Ranger suits. I've been out and bought this bad boy, and I think it looks absolutely fantastic. The detail already is on it that's great. I'm going to do something similar to what I did with the Iron Man, because if you think about it, pretty much do look identical. I'm going to be lighting up his chest plate, and on each side light up that. I'm thinking about doing a full custom respray paint again like I did with the Iron Man, but that didn't go very well in places. I'm not too sure, I might just highlight the different areas, but look at that figure, it's absolutely fantastic. The detail on the front and back, you haven't skimped at all. So that's another upcoming custom figure. Also, I've had this guy sat in the background of my videos for God knows how long, and I have no idea what to do with him, but I have finally thought of something to do with him, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn him into like a Knight of the Round Table custom knight, obviously Knight, the Dark Knight, Batman, complete with full metal armor, metal helmet, and with a sword. So that's another upcoming custom. I've also got loads of projects on. Batman helmet, I've been out and given a spray with some silver spray paint as a base coat, and now I'm going to go in with the detail with the battle damage as well, highlighting all the scratches. Placing down there. So yeah guys, that is what I'm up to at the moment. I also have a Kylo Ren figure that you might have seen in the background. I'm tinkering with trying to get his lightsaber to light up. I've had loads of different ways of trying to do it, and none of them have really done, well, I have to explain, they're not really lights lit up as much as I wanted to on the lightsaber. There's not much really customization I need to do with the actual figure, but yeah, that's another one. So guys, thank you so much for the subscribers and the likes and the comments, absolutely fantastic, blown me away. So let's move on to the thumbnail of this video, the 18 or 19 inch, I always get mixed up, it's about 18 inches, Robin, well, the Batman, from Batman v Superman figure, customization into the Robin suit. Enjoy.
Okay guys, so the way I've got rid of the bat signal, or the bat emblem on his chest, is first I used a Stanley knife to shave off the actual shape and try and smooth it in as much as possible with his chest all the way around, and then I've used sandpaper to smooth it over. the add-on for the Robin suit, and that will sit nicely there. Next I'm going to be doing the two lines that run down his chest, followed by the buckles. As you can see, I've used a Stanley knife and carved a line down the centre of his chest, and I've cut two thin strips of craft foam, and I'm going to be gluing them side by side down the chest, and then I've glued the buckles over the top. Just using good old fashioned super glue. And this one has dried up, so let's try another one. Seams now glued on. Next, let's glue on the R for Robin. So just off camera I've got a lot of reference photos of the Robin suit, so I'm just looking at the reference photos now just so I know where to position the R so it's on correctly. Dried super glue off my fingers for days now. So it's actually placed at a slight angle, like so. mission requires a restart. That's not good. Okay, that's that now glued on. Next thing is to do the buckles, which I'll be cutting out of craft form as well. First I'm going to have to restart my computer so I can actually see the reference photos, and then we'll carry on from there. Okay, looking at the reference photos, the next one is just below the R. Then the next one is on the bottom of his ribs, just about there. And again, looking at reference photos, the line here, buckle rests directly in line there. With the bottom of the buckle sitting on the top of that line. Replace the belt. The last buckle sits just above the belt, so about there, with a little gap. Okay guys, that's the stuck on as well as the buckles for the Robin suit. Okay, this is the Batman head from the 18 inch Batman figure, and once I cut his head off the body, I originally put it on the 12 inch and it kind of made it look like a bobblehead, but what I'm going to do now is I'm going to attempt to cut around the eyes and around the nose, just so you've got that bit as an eyepiece, and try and make it look like Robin's eyepiece for his costume. So yep, I'm going to attempt to cut around it first, cut the back off, cut the mouthpiece off, and then try and shape this into Robin's eyepiece. Thank you. Okay, you're probably wondering when did I go ahead and make the spear for the Robin suit, but don't worry, I am going to take you through it step by step. So, first of all, I used the same type of ear widener that I used for the Batman v Superman mech armor kryptonite spear, and all I've done is I've sawn off the end just to use the end piece for the pointy end of the spear. For the wiring, or the steel wire that runs through the entire of the spear, I've used earbuds, plain and simple, and that's just hot glued into the end there and hot glued into the perspex hollow tubing that I've used for the main base of the spear. And again, using reference photos, the spear is actually broken in the middle, and then you have a little bit of the steel wiring showing. Again, using earbuds, the plastic earbuds, and what you can see here, the green you can see here, is actually a bit of green foam that I've had to wrap around the earbuds, because it was actually too thin. So I've just glued a bit of foam onto the earbud, the blue earbuds, and then fed it into this hollow tubing, and then super glued it in. Then moving down, again, all using the same stuff, just using reference photos. That's actually insta-glued back in place. But here I've used the green foam to do the point, the spike, and the cross spear. So, all just super glued together. The next thing I need to do is give it a paint. And that'll be the spear complete. Okay guys, halfway through painting, my battery died on my camera, so it didn't catch me doing all of this, but this is just a base coat. I've mixed black, grey and some gold together, and this has given it just the base coat for the entire thing. And now I'm going to go in and put the detail into the buckles, the Robin chest logo, and I'll be doing detail on the belt and weathering up some more. Okay guys, using reference photos on my computer, as you can see, I've gone ahead and started to score in damage marks in the relevant places, and also on the gauntlet there, and then I'm going to be using some black paint just to highlight the scratches so it jumps out and pops from the rest of the figure.
So guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. I just want to point out a few things that I forgot to mention during the tutorial. First of all, I was going to sand away all the design on all over the whole suit. I obviously didn't end up doing that because when I put the buckles and the strip on his chest with the ha 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 graffiti, it actually takes your eye away from the fact that there isn't any design like the rest of the suit. Plus the fact when I did remove the Batman emblem, the scratch is actually added to the battle damage effect. And I also did mention about the steel tubing. These are the hollow steel tubing that I got from my local B&Q. It's the same one I used on the Batman armoured mech suit that I used for his kryptonite spear. And all I've done, as you saw in the video, is chipped away the leg and then put quite a bit of hot glue into the bottom of the boots, stuck the steel tubing in and left it to dry, and same with under the leg there and in his arms. And apart from that, I think that's everything. I'm really happy with how I managed to recycle the Batman head into the Robin eye mask. So guys, thank you very much for watching. Please like and subscribe. I'm over the moon with how all the positive responses and comments. And I'll see you for the next video. Cheers.